Hey, Charles, when you look at the league, just I know you say only three teams have a chance. Give me one other team that if they get a piece, or let's say their superstar decides to play like a superstar, that they have a chance. Who would that be?
Oh, it's easily the Philadelphia 76ers. If Joel Embiid play like he's capable of, or Ben Simmons picks up his level, that's the only other team can get in the conversation. You got two guys who can dominate a game anytime they're on the court, but they're inconsistent. But it's Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. That's the only other team I see could get in the equation. Because, like I say, you know, Giannis don't have no running mate. But if Embiid and Simmons start doing their thing, they got two great players against one. And obviously, two great players compared to one gives you an advantage. But the only other team I see doing that is Philadelphia.
I think it's just too easy to ask you about Joel Embiid. I mean, every single show on the planet's asked you about him this week, about why he's got to be in your bonnet.
Well, you know, Susie, I said this when I was doing Mike Wilbon's and Tony Cook's Card the Interruption, which is a great show, two of my favorite people. And Marshall knows this. Your best players, and it sounds stupid when I say it, your best players have to be your best players. Like when Marshall was the best running back in the NFL, anyone going to survive with the backup. Marshall had to be Marshall Faulk.
Yep.
I mean, I think some people, like, yo, man, you our best player. Be our best player. You can't ask role players and backups to be your best players and carry you every night. That's why they're role players and backups. They're not as good as starters. So I challenge Joel Embiid, be the best player on the court every night. Listen, when you watch the Milwaukee Bucks play, you know Giannis is going to be the best player on his team and on the court most nights. And then everybody else is going to follow. But if your best player is out there and he's not going to be the best player every night, your team is not going to win. Because, Susie, the NBA is different than other sports. And what I mean by that is, you have to win 4 out of 7. This is not a one-and-done scenario where a role player or a bench guy can go crazy one night and steal a football game or pitch a great game in baseball or have a great night in hockey. In the NBA, you have to beat a team 4 times in a week. And if your best players don't lead you, you're not going to win. It's plain and simple.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.